Hi, I'm Scotty. If you want to learn how to service and repair antique mechanical clocks, then subscribe to my channel. Welcome to Scotties Clock World. This is a Chinese made 15 day Polaris clock movement. That's the back of the movement with twin hammers. Down there, the first thing we're going to do is remove the hammers and that guide block up there, so that when we take the pendulum leader off, this piece here, it'll sit flat on our working block. We'll take that off first. Find Phillips head screwdriver number one. If it comes, tighten it down to make sure we don't lose it. Put it in a bag of parts, put it aside. Now, using our 5mm spanner, we'll loosen this nut off up here. Take that off. Oh, look at the oil on that. It's been over-oiled. As tends to be a problem with people playing around with clock movements they don't know anything about. Oil doesn't solve the problem of a clock not working. Flooding with oil isn't going to help. Clean that little bit off first. We'll get rid of that when it goes through the ultrasonic and before it goes. Look at the oil on that. See the gunk that's coming off that? That's excess oil that people have put on the movement. It's flowed out, run down, and collect the dust and become a grinding compound for the wheels. You can probably see how oily that is. Heaps of oil on that wheel. Right, before we go any further, we'll have to let down the springs, because there's sure to be some tension still in them. Now, let down tool number 8 for the winding arbor. 6 is the average size, they tend to be 6s, but this is an 8. So, get that stable on the block, put a little bit of pressure on it to wind the spring up, then pull back the click. Let the wind down tool run round in your hand to let the spring down. Okay, strike side. Turn it round so you can see it. I think the strike side is wound up pretty tightly. Yeah. Okay, once again, number 8 let down tool onto the winding arbor. Turn it slightly and then put your screwdriver into the click. And let the lockdown tool spin round in your hand slowly till all the pressure's gone. Right, that's done. Now that we'll let the pressure out of the mainspring, we can now take the pendulum leader off this piece here, because the pallets sitting up there that work on the escape wheel that you can see turning there, if there's any pressure on that, that'll dramatically rush away and quite possibly damage some of your wheels. So we'll take the back cock off. That's this piece here, called the back cock. That's the suspension spring, and that's the pendulum leader. That part under the back there, if I get close enough, that part there is the crutch. Right, so here we go, taking this off, or do we need bigger? Nope, it works okay. First screw out. Second screw out. Now, we can remove the back cock and the pendulum leader. And now the crutch and pallets come out. That's the crutch and pallets there. Put that in the going side train. Pendulum leader. And the back cock. We'll put the two screws for the back cock, small container. Keep them separate so I don't get them mixed up. We'll put that over there with the back cock. Turn the movement over. We're now ready to start taking the movement apart. First thing we'll do is we'll take the spring. Off the rack that keeps tension on the rack. Might as well take the rack off while we're here. It's got a circlip on it. A little bit tight. Squeeze it off with this pair of pliers. And then the pliers on the back, get a grip on it. Doesn't want to let go. There it is. It's also a bit bent out of shape, so we'll check that and straighten it before we put it back on again. There's the rack. Now we'll take this circlip off here. It's got him, off he comes. Look at the oil on that. Now the snail will come off. Take that gear there off. Now we can see what we've got.